So there's so much about graphing inequalities that is like graphing equations. The best way to do it is when your inequality is in the same form as y equals mx plus b. At this point, if you have a Chromebook open, I need it closed. You should have this paper ready, and we're going to transform this inequality into y equals mx plus b. What do we need to move first? The 2x. It's a positive 2x, so we're going to subtract it from both sides of the inequality. What's left on the left side of our inequality? -3y, be careful not to lose those negatives, is less than, and I want this in y equals mx plus b form, so I'm going to put that -2x here and the plus 12 here. Is the y by itself yet? What's with it? And we're going to divide by the -3. It's an inequality, so what happens when I divide by a negative? The sign flips. We've been through why that happens. We now have a single y is equal to 2/3 x minus 4. Why is the 2/3 positive? Because the 2 was negative and the 3 was negative, so those divide out. And we end up with 12 divided by -3 gives us -4. Okay, we're going to skip down to the bottom part of this paper first. Because if you recall, when we graph inequalities on a number line, we had open and closed circles, yes? When we're graphing inequalities on a coordinate plane, we have dashed or solid lines. And it's related to the open and closed circles. Solid line is going to be greater than or equal to, and less than or equal to.
Yeah, there's two distracting forms in there.
How do you do it on the bench?
On the bench.
Yeah. Broken line, what do you guys predict? Just less than or just greater than? And just like on a number line, once we have our open or closed circle, with a number line, we draw a line to the right or to the left, correct? I want you to think about that with shading. We'll be shading above or shading below. If we shade above, it's going to be when it's greater than or equal to or greater than. Just like we would have the arrows go to the right. And keeping in mind that the x-axis is like that will help us as we start doing this shading. Shading below is going to be less than or equal to or less than. So with that information, we're going to go up and we're going to actually make our first graph. First, you need to identify what is the slope, and we have what for our slope here? 2 over 3, so our rise is 2, our run is 3. And what is our y-intercept? -4. So just like when we're graphing equations with an inequality, we start with our plus b, which in this case our plus b is a -4. So down on the y-axis, we're going to put a point at -4. We're going to make two more points using our slope. We're going to rise up how much?
2.
And run across 3. And I'd like to do that one more time, but it's going to be slightly off the graph. It'll end up right here. This is where I asked you to get a straight edge. Because we have to think, is this a broken line or a solid line? What kind of symbol do we have? Greater than, so it's not going to be a solid line. And I want you guys to watch how I do it. I'm using a pen, so I'm just going to make a dashed line here. If you have a pencil, you could draw the solid line and then go back and erase parts of it. This line, by the way, has a name. We call it the boundary line. It's greater than, so we're shading above. So take your colored pencil and just shade this area above where the boundary line is, because we're showing where all of the possible answers are.